What is up, boys and one girl watching this video? My name is Nick and welcome back to another Call of Duty World War II video. And today we're going to be talking about how Call of Duty is finally saved, how everybody feels so hype about this COD, and I have five reasons, actually six because there's a little bonus reason that I just found out right before recording this video, six reasons why Call of Duty is freaking amazing this year. And I do want to apologize to you guys for yesterday's video. I know a lot of people got angry because I made a video talking about dislikes before the game even came out, but to be honest guys, those were pretty much just petty dislikes that I have. I always make a video before the game comes out talking about like what I dislike about it, just in case, like, you know, they do decide to change something in the game, I could always go back and say like, well, they finally changed that, right? But nonetheless guys, thank you for coming on to this video. I hope you guys can like kind of forgive me for yesterday. If you guys can smack that like button on this video, I am super hyped guys. We have literally less than like 48 hours left until COD World War II is out. I literally cannot wait. Like I'm so damn excited. If you guys are excited, make sure to leave a comment down below letting me know what you love about this game. The one thing you love the most about this game, let me know down in the comments below. Guys, if you're new around here, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Let's get straight into it. So the first point here, guys, this is just a bonus point. You guys might be really excited about this. I don't know if you guys are going to be like me, but I was so excited when I saw this leak. It is a leak that somebody posted and stuff. So paint jobs are back. Guys, paint jobs are finally back. In Black Ops 3, we had the ability to paint our weapons and stuff, and now we have the ability to do it all over again. But I think this time it's a little different. I'm not sure if there's only one area on the gun that you could paint, but you might be able to do the entire weapon. And if you could do the entire weapon, that in my books is completely amazing. Like, I really cannot wait. I am super excited. I love paint jobs, and I had so much fun on Black Ops 3 making like paint jobs and stuff like that, but after a while I just stopped doing it. But once you have every gun painted, I think it's cool because it's unique, it's whatever, and if you can make your own camo out of that, that is pretty cool in my opinion, guys. Going to the actual list, guys, we're going to start off at number 5, and I'm going to say I really love the fact that classic weapons are back. The PPSH, the 1911, the STG-44, all these classic Call of Duty weapons that we haven't seen in years because we had all these made-up futuristic weapons. I think it feels good to finally have some classic weapons back in Call of Duty. I'm so happy that they're here. It's like, it's really damn great. And another thing I want to talk about is at point number 4, guys. You know I love 3-lane maps, but these maps aren't your basic 3-lane maps. These maps are actually really good. They're well thought out. Like, I think a lot of people, they had complaints that in the beta, the maps weren't that great. But if you think about it, the maps are actually really good. There's more flank routes. There's more everything. I don't know. It's just something about the maps. They may look a little ugly. Don't get me wrong. The colors may be a little grayscaled and stuff like that. But it's World War II, guys. What do you want, right? It's not going to be rainbows and stuff like that. I for one, think they look great. I, for one, think they're going to play amazingly. And I'm really happy with the maps, guys. Let's go on to point number 3. And this one is a basic one. Everybody knows that this point's coming up in this video. And that is the fact that we're back to boots on the ground. Call of Duty hasn't been there for the past 3 years. And finally, we are back with boots on the ground. Now, Advanced Warfare is Sledgehammer Games. They're the ones who brought the futuristic. And they're the ones who also brought boots on the ground back. So I'm thankful for that. Boots on the ground is my favorite type of Call of Duty. I like jumping and stuff, don't get me wrong, but I mean, every single year, 3 years in a row is kind of annoying. It wouldn't bother me if it was 1 year out of three that we had like a futuristic COD. It would be okay, but I think boots on the ground, that's where Call of Duty really deserves. That's where they belong, man. That's where COD belongs, boots on the ground. Hopefully you guys could agree. If you do agree with that, make sure to smack the like button because boots on the ground CODs are always the best, guys. Going down to point number 2, I just want to say, yes, I did complain about there only being 9 maps yesterday's video, but I do want to also say that this is also a good thing because that means they worked really hard on campaign, they worked really hard on zombies, they worked really hard on the multiplayer maps, and they worked really hard on the 4th war mode. And I think it's really cool that we have 4 modes like that, because war, it's its own whole thing. It has 3 maps, it's probably going to get DLC maps as well. We may get like 3 multiplayer maps in the DLC, 1 zombie and 1 war. It might be something like that, which in my opinion is pretty cool. And I think it's really, really great that Sledgehammer, they're actually putting so much time into this game. They're putting so much effort into this game. Like, they traveled all through Europe just to like get all these historical facts right and accurate for the campaign. Like, they put so much time in this. Now, I heard the campaign is only 5 hours long, but that's a typical Call of Duty for you. And if it's great, if the story's great, I'm fine with that. The zombies leaked gameplay, super damn good. All the multiplayer maps that I've seen look really good, and war, in my opinion, I haven't tried it yet, but from what everyone is saying, it sounds like it's a really, really fun game mode. Going to the number 1 reason, guys, that I love this game, I think this game is going to save Call of Duty. And let's just talk about saving Call of Duty for a second. Everybody quit Call of Duty. So many people started quitting Call of Duty. I'm not gonna say everybody. I didn't quit. I'm sure you didn't quit. You're watching this video. But a lot of people stopped playing after Ghost because that's when the franchise kind of went downhill. And because of that, so many people left. They just stopped playing. Now a lot of people are coming back. So many people are back to Call of Duty. I'm reading all over the internet. Like, people are saying, I haven't bought COD in years, and this one I'm really interested in. I bought it. I pre-ordered all this stuff. So it's like, I'm really happy about that. But guys, let's just get to the number one point here. This one, you guys may not agree with, you guys may agree with, I don't know, but I'm super happy that score streaks aren't overpowered. They're not made to be overpowered in this game, and I think that's really, really good because I'm the type of player that I like to run and gun. Sure, if I get like a big score streak, like let's say dogs or something, if it's in the game, I'll be happy to get that, but I don't want my dogs to just completely obliterate. Okay, I do want my dogs to obliterate the other team, but I don't want to get obliterated by dogs. That's how everybody is in Call of Duty. You want to do good, but you don't want to die, obviously. That's how it is. That's Call of Duty, guys. But I mean, it kind of sucks. Let's say you're in a game and then there's just score streaks everywhere. It's like, come on, dude. I know you got a lot of points. I know you got your score streaks. I know you're good, but I don't want to die 100 times from some helicopter in the air because I spawn outside and it shoots me right away, right? So I think it's really good that the score streaks aren't overpowered. I think all these points actually that I'm in right now, this is what I think is going to save Call of Duty, all these things. And I just wanted to talk about one more thing, guys. This isn't a point that I love or anything, but the way you open supply drops in this game, I can't show you guys a video, but it's so, so cool. You're walking around in the little area, I forget, the headquarters. You're walking around in the headquarters, you pull out your supply drop as if you were like to call in a care package. So you pull it out like that, as if you had a little smoke thing to call your care package in. You throw it onto the ground, and then your supply drop falls from a helicopter and it opens up. And I think that's really cool as well. Like that's just one of the leaks I saw as well, guys. It's so cool. Like, I'm super, super hyped for this game. Let me know if you guys are hyped down in the comments below. Make sure to smack that like button if you guys do enjoy this video. If you guys think COD is going to be saved finally, let me know down in the comments, guys. Like, hashtag COD is saved. Like, it is, guys. I'm so damn happy. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching this video. Subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. And please turn on those notifications if you guys want to be notified. I'm going to be uploading every single day Call of Duty World War II videos. So if you guys want to, like, stay hyped for that, I'm going to have tips. I'm going to have live gameplays. I'm going to have everything. I'm Mythbusters, every single thing World War II related for you guys. All right, my name is Nick. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.